Stop. We are in. Stop. I'll show you more in a little while. It's obviously. I can't move without that. This bit right here. That bit right there. Yeah. And that motherfucker right there. Yeah. So.
A plan for the evening. I'm going to go for a cigarette. And then maybe a shower, if I can be bothered. Then a little bit later on, we're gonna get some food. Maybe lots of food. I'll show you some of that food later. And then we're gonna watch Payback. Backlash was
like a couple of weeks ago.
4 weeks ago.
Yeah.
So Payback, and then we're gonna go to sleep. And then tomorrow it is Jimmy Carr Day. So. Yeah. Should be fun. Should be very good fun. So, we'll catch you tomorrow.
Well, good morning, everybody. It is Monday. Is it Monday?
Yeah, all day.
Yeah, it's Monday. It's Jimmy Carr. It's 11:30, yeah, 11:30. Jimmy Carr Day. We woke up about an hour ago.
Because exactly
we were up last night late watching the Payback pay-per-view for WWE.
Completely fucked up,
yeah.
So.
Yeah, so we were up late last night watching Payback wrestling pay-per-view, so that finished at about 2:30, which is good. So we went to bed, and then now we have breakfast.
Fuck yeah.
So I will show you what we have in our breakfast.
So this is our breakfast. Nice little breakfast box.
I would have done this, but I've already opened mine.
Yeah, Dan's kind of decombobulated his. So we have some cornflakes, some orange juice, some milk for the cornflakes, cute little pan of chocolate, which looks quite nice, and a flapjack.
I think the pan of chocolate kind of looks like a sausage roll.
Yeah, it does a bit. It looks quite good though.
The chocolate
Rise and Refuel Company. Yeah, Dan said earlier that it looks a bit like a Grey's box, but yeah.
So our plan for the morning is have breakfast.
Yeah.
And then we're probably gonna chill out for a little bit and then maybe take a wander over to the venue, see if we can sort of scope it out a little bit. We don't have to be there until 6:00 tonight. We've got an hour's arrival window, which is brilliant.
Maybe bathe.
Yeah, we'll probably get showers and stuff in a little bit. We're just like kind of trying to combobulate ourselves this morning. So we're watching a bit of telly while we have breakfast, and then we'll get ourselves properly ready and maybe take a wander out somewhere. We've got leftover pizza for lunch, which is brilliant as well. Oh, we forgot to film pizza last night.
Show them the boxes.
Yeah, I'll show you the pizza boxes. Pizza over there. Very good pizza from a place called Top Top Pizza. Top Top Pizza in Gosforth. I can definitely recommend it. Lovely pizzas. Great service as well. The guy that delivered them was wonderful, really friendly. So yeah, we're going to have breakfast and then we'll check in with you guys a little bit later on. In a bit.
So we're going to hear a little bit early. try and figure out what's what. And we're right at the front. So that's the view we've got. It's great. Just testing the lights at the moment by the looks of it. So we have a marvellous view for Jimmy's incredibly obnoxious laugh. Check in a little bit to get more get some more footage from the show. I'll check you in a little bit, guys. See you later. Set it on fire. The pavement. Ha 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 ha!
Nothing.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Ta-da! Well. Cut that, shall we? Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. You well?
Yeah.
What's your name? What's three? Esby. Esme. Esme. Hi, Esme. Properly ginger as well, if you don't mind me saying. Wow. Yeah, that's why ginger means disability, isn't it, Esme? You can park where you fucking like with that colouring. You look as if you get sunburned checking the phone. Factor 50 for you. Just a look in a fridge. What do you think, Esme, of the term ginger? Do you like it or not? You think it's quite cool, the term ginger? Well, that's certainly the right attitude, Esme, and also, the fuck are you going to do about it? I'm not a big fan of the term ginger, because I think it's got a bit of edge to it, hasn't it, ginger? Like, if you say someone is blonde or brunette, it is merely a descriptor, right? You're just describing the colour of their hair. It's not a big deal. Ginger, it's got a bit of edge. Even if you say nicely, ginger's got a bit of edge. Ginger is just a whisker away from ginger. Some offence. It's not easy being homeless, constantly searching for a safe place to spend the night, begging for change, getting hit by my car. Trampoline. Sounds like a product for cleaning homeless men. Trampoline for the dirty hobo, and now new trampette for the female vagrant. Ta-da! Thanks very much. I've had a special request this evening from a lady in a wheelchair, but I'm going to ignore it and continue with the show. I was on a Virgin train last year, travelling up to Edinburgh, and the tannoy announcement said, if you see something that doesn't look right, talk to a member of staff. So I reported a man in his 50s with an earring. Are there couples in? Give us a shout, all the couples in the room. Well, there exists in our nation a great divide. Bathroom door open people and bathroom door closed people. Where are the bathroom door closed people? Give us a shout.
Where have you gone?
And where are the bathroom door open people? Get out, you fucking animals. We've got shit to do and we don't need a fucking audience for it. Okay. Someone asked me, because I work with Rachel quite closely, and men will ask me, like, they'll come up to me in a bar, restaurant, wherever I happen to be. They won't even say hello to me. They'll just go, have you fought Rachel Riley? Like, dudes. Yeah. But you've got to promise not to tell her. She just thinks she gets sleepy when she drinks. No, I'm saying I would. Get half a chance. Give me half a chance, Christ. Be like a rat off a drainpipe. I would. I'm just saying. I mean, I don't want to be crude, but I would ride her like a stolen bike. Sorry, I'm not being clear. What I'm saying is I would crawl over broken glass to suck the cock of the last man that fucked her.
Yeah!
That's what I'm saying. Honestly, like, everyone knows 6 million Jewish people lost their lives to the Nazis during World War II. But a lot of people don't know, because it's not really taught in our schools, a lot of people don't know the Nazis also killed in their thousands gypsies, homosexuals, disabled people and Jehovah's Witnesses. No one knows what happened with the Jehovah's Witnesses. You'd have to assume some Jehovah's Witnesses came a-knocking on the gates of a death camp with a copy of a magazine called Watchtower. Some enterprising Nazi guard, oh yes, come in. Very interested in your magazine, Watchtower. We have the Watchtowers here. Long journey, maybe you'd like to freshen up and maybe take a shower. Wow, a fucking creepy Nazi, Jesus. 8 words now to end a career. Can you do it? Of course he fucking can. Have a little faith. You can prevent any rape. Just say yes. It's not, was that a lady shouting, it's not rape if you shout surprise? Be careful if you're thinking of getting a rescue cat. My nan had a fall the other day and has literally sat next to her and did fuck all. Bloody rip-off, aren't they, when you think about it? My wife wanted to spice things up by playing doctors and nurses, so I put her on a trolley in the hallway and ignored her for 48 hours. My boyfriend has 12 nipples. Sounds funny, doesn't it?
Oh.
My dad recently died because we couldn't remember his blood type. As he was dying, he kept insisting for us to be positive. But it's been hard with our... Oh, funny. My pal Jack has just split up with his girlfriend. Do you have any advice on how to get back on the poon train, lad?
Well, we're back in the hotel. Jimmy Carr was incredible. It was a brilliant night. Nice to actually be at a gig again instead of watching live streams and stuff. It was great to hear the crowd. It was very cold towards the end of it though, obviously being an outdoor gig, you're not packed in. But we survived, it was brilliant. Back at the hotel, we're gonna order some food and then probably watch a little bit of YouTube or telly or something and then get some sleep ready for Bill Bailey tomorrow. So we will see you guys tomorrow and hopefully we'll have another good night. Bye bye. Well, good morning, everyone. It is Tuesday. Yeah, Tuesday.
Half past 11, Tuesday morning.
Yeah, 11:30. We have our breakfast. About to scram that. And today is the day of Bill Bailey. So I look god awful. I've got things everywhere. But oh well, it's going to be a good day. So plan for today: breakfast.
Yes.
And then.
Catch up on Raw from last night.
Yeah, we're going to watch some Raw. Do a bit more editing for this vlog, and then chill out for a bit before we go to Bill Bailey. Really big thank you as well to the Virgin Money Arena because we didn't manage to get accessible tickets for Bill Bailey today, but we spoke to Charlie,
wonderful young Charlie,
who was absolutely amazing, who managed to sort us out disabled access again and the same pitch that we had last night, so we'll be right in front of the stage, which is brilliant. Yes, so happy birthday, Charlie, for today. So yeah, hopefully,
if you see this, chances are you'll be.
Yeah, probably not. But you know, we should have a good night tonight, and hopefully we'll see Charlie again. Wish him happy birthday, probably maybe buy him a drink, and then yeah, should have a good night for Bill Bailey tonight. Jimmy Carr was brilliant. We ended up going to bed about midnight, something like that.
Just after midnight.
Yeah. So we had a bit of an earlier one last night because we've basically been going to bed at like 2 a.m. for the last 5 nights. But yeah, no, it should be a good day. So we will check in with you guys a little bit later on.
It's going to be great fun. I'm really looking forward to seeing Bill. Very, very funny man.
Say hi, Dan.
What's happening? I'm knackered. My back hurts. Sitting in a wheelchair. And if you're a wheelchair user yourself, you'll understand, you'll know exactly how bad it is. I was in the chair for 5 hours.
Yeah, something like that.
5 hours solid. And obviously intermittent throughout the day, going down and what have you. And my back is fucked today. I'm in a lot of pain. But I'm on enough pain medication to not really care about it. So let's see how the rest of the day goes. And, you know, yesterday I couldn't go to the toilet. Today I'm going too much. It's one extreme to the other.
Yeah.
When you've got a fucked bowel. But what can you do? Stay tuned. It's going to be a really, really fun day. We're going to have a great fun. We're going to be checking in with you guys throughout the day. And we'll promise. I promise you. We'll record the journey this time.
Yes. Yeah. We had a bit of a nightmare yesterday trying to get to it. The sat-nav took us to the wrong place. But by chance I saw a sign for the race course. But it was brilliant, so yeah, we'll film the journey today as well, which will be good. I mean, it's literally like 5 minutes around the corner from the hotel, so it's not too bad.
4 minutes door to door.
Yeah, it wasn't that much at all, but well, you know, we'll film the journey and coming into the car park and stuff, so give you guys a bit, and might even film going from the car to the pod, although we will have to like stop filming at some point because we have to, you know, check tickets and all that kind of thing. But yeah, see you guys in a bit.
Alright guys, so we're back again, but this time it's for Bill Bailey. So I'm very, very, very much looking forward to this. And I've just been informed that my old boss is here somewhere. So that should be an interesting thing. Looking forward to seeing him, it'd be great. I mean, it'll be a very socially distanced greeting, but let's hope Bill Bailey's good. I'm sure he will be. And I'll speak to you guys in a little bit. See you soon. Bye bye.
Welcome to the stage, the comedy stylings of Bill Bailey. One place for 6 months, I'm freaking out! I've seen some amazing sights in my life. I've been lucky enough to dive with whales off the Great Barrier Reef. I've seen volcanoes at dawn. I've even seen falafels being made by hand on the streets of Hammersmith. But tonight, a socially distanced racecourse just outside Newcastle, it's one of the most beautiful sights I've ever seen! Yeah. Thank God, so you don't rush the stage. It's a bit of a call and response. Get the lungs working, warm you up a bit. Here we go. All the leaves are brown.
The leaves are brown.
And the sky is grey.
And the sky is grey.
I went for a walk.
Went for a walk.
On such a winter's day.
On a winter's day.
I'll be safe and warm.
I'll be safe and warm.
If I was in LA.
If I was in LA.
California dreaming.
California dreaming.
Such a lovely
day. Is somebody on helium down the front here?
California dreaming.
We're going to do it again until we get it right. All the leaves are brown.
All the leaves are brown.
And the sky is grey.
And the sky is grey.
Actually, do you know what? I like to sing it in the German. Let's try. Du bist mein Sonnenschein. Who wants to sing it in German? Come on.
Hey!
Have we got any German people in? Way more than I expected. Sind Sie Deutsch?
Ja!
Nein! Ein bisschen Deutsch. All right then, I think there's enough German. I'm gonna start the show again. I'm gonna do it in German, see how far we get. Right, put some German music on, we'll start again. Right, here we go. Jawohl! Willkommen! Das Riesenkursen! Surrounding Aryan. Willkommen! Sind Sie gut, ja?
Ja!
Ausgezeichnet! Ja, ich habe ein Jazz-Button. Ja. Und der Backstop? Ja. oh, ich habe eine the barbecue and dingen. Für ein non-endoscopy haben gehen. Und sagt, das wird wir sehen. Ich sag, ja. Ein Termin haben. Ja, man kann mit dem Kopf spielen. Ja. Mit dem Kopf. Man kann mit dem Kopf spielen.
Yes, it is I. Still here, hooray! Woohoo! Yes, I was asked if I would appear on the popular TV programme Strictly Come Dancing. But, yes. And I said, and they were trying to persuade me. And they said, do you want to do it? And I said, I tell you what, I said, I'll do it under one condition. And she said, what was that? I said, if my family had been kidnapped by terrorists, and weirdly, appearing on the show is a condition of their release. And she said, what sort of terrorists? Huh? So, who knows? Anyway, it's a strange old time.
Mood, you know. And while we're on the subject of Hollywood, there's a bit of a Hollywood insider information for you. The original director of Lord of the Rings was not actually Peter Jackson. No, originally slated to be Quentin Tarantino. I would have loved to have seen that. We open on the show. Freeze frame. Bruce Willis is Frodo. Macaulay Culkin is gone. Samuel L. Jackson is Gandalf. Somebody get these mother orcs out of this mother goddamn mother god Mordor. All right. Who loves an otter?
Yeah!
Aquatic theme. You make my heart sing. Otter. Let's try that again. Aquatic theme. You make my heart sing.
Otter. Otter.
This is one of the strangest nights of my life. But in a good way. In a good way. Is there any metal fans in?
Yeah!
Pause a few. This is basically all metal, right? Just right. This is most metal right now. Oh. Metal right there, right? Most songs sound better in a metal style.
Never seen you looking so lovely as you look tonight. Never seen you shine so bright. You were amazing, lady.
That sounds better. And what I love about metal, right? There's a chord in a metal, it's called a diminished fifth, which constitutes most of metal. And if I was I'd love to be in a metal band. If I was allowed to at home, I'd have amplifiers in every room in the house. I'd have a guitar around my neck, and I would just play metal all day long. As I walk from room to room, walking in the lounge.
Walking through to the kitchen. Do you want some breakfast?
Yes, I do.
What do you want? Cornflakes. What kind of milk? Send me skills. Pouring on the milk. Finish. Put in my body.
bong, someone at the door. I'll go walking down the hall. I got this. I'm giving my life to the life of Satan. The Dark Lord dwells inside. Beelzebub lives in my mind. I'm giving my life to the Prince of Life. The Prince of Life. The Prince.
Well, that is the end of our second day of gigs. Bill Bailey was absolutely incredible. I think that was probably the better of the two gigs, I think.
Absolutely agree.
Yeah. But no, it was absolutely amazing. Had such a great time. It's been nice to actually go to a gig and not just sit and watch stuff online. But yeah, we're going to get to bed. And tomorrow we're going back home, sadly. But no, it's been incredible. What are your thoughts, Dan?
I'm fucked. I'm tired. But I've had so much fun. Other than a slight panic earlier.
but we're not getting to that because that's just fucking disgusting. We're all good. It's been a great weekend. It's been nice to get away for a few days. Not have to put up with family. Quite frankly, I love them, but they can fuck off. And in terms of accessibility, the site wasn't great.
You've got to think though, it is on grass as well, which is kind of difficult to manage, but they could have done it a little bit better.
It's on grass, but then again, so is the most successfully accessible festival in the country.
This is true. This is very true.
So, to that. although this was knocked up in 6 months. So, 5 months.
Yeah.
So, I'll give them that. However, yeah, the terrain wasn't great. The facilities were passable, they were there, you could use them, wasn't a lot of room, but you do what you've got to do, you get in, you get out, you know, the staff though, are unbelievable. Shout out to Charlie, happy birthday Charlie, and Jordan as well, my dear friend Jordan, who I used to work for. I saw today, which was wonderful. Shout out to you too, brother. And good luck for the rest of the run, Virgin. Hope it goes well. Best of luck. Thank you.
So yeah, there we go. Yeah, access was okay. It wasn't brilliant. It wasn't terrible. It could have done with a bit of work. Maybe some more. They had like rubber.
Some more grass.
So they had like rubber matting on the ground for the entrances, which was brilliant because, you know, once you actually got onto the matting, it was relatively smooth.
I think plywood would have been better.
Yeah.
Plywood boards.
Maybe some more boarding to go down would be brilliant. But, you know, incredible both
Something
nights.
Something that doesn't have fucking gomping big fucking studs.
Yeah. So the way they fixed the boards to the ground was with big metal sort of U-shaped pegs, and if you got your wheel stuck on one of them, it just wasn't brilliant.
I think 3 out of the 4 trips to the toilet yesterday we were grinding.
Yeah, we ended up grinding a wheel against the boards, but no, it was brilliant. And to get front row as well was absolutely incredible. Thank you Charlie for sorting that out.
Yeah,
for
awesome.
Tonight, but yeah, we're gonna call it a night. Thank you for watching if you've made it this far into the video. Thank you so much.
Maybe have another beer.
Yeah. But yes, don't forget, this is our first video, so please like, send us a comment, subscribe if you want to. There'll hopefully be many more of these, and hopefully, yeah, hopefully the next one is going to be Damnation Festival in Leeds, if that still goes ahead.
First of November,
I think. Yeah. At the moment, it's still going ahead, but with it being an indoor venue and social distancing and everything, we don't know yet, but as of now it is still going ahead, so that is planned to be our next vlog. So hopefully we'll see you there. But yes, like, comment, subscribe, send us a message if there's anything you want to see on the channel. We are going to be doing a little bit of a background video of the story of how we got here and everything, hopefully in the next month or so. But yes, thank you for watching, and we hope to see you again soon.
We love you guys.